Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another exciting Propaganda Cast with me, your host, Imperial Dane, Master Propaganda, here of Psych, Defender of the Fatherland. Off here to another exciting Propaganda Cast, a 1 vs 1 here on Fame and Will. I'm still looking for a good 2 vs 2. So yeah, that'll probably be a bit longer. Maybe tomorrow, maybe the day after tomorrow, or maybe next week. I don't know. I'm generally always looking every day to just have to find something. Also, big thanks to Jason for donating to the Propaganda Cast and the war effort. Most appreciated. A big thumbs up from here. Off to the episode itself, we got Jessen here in the east, fighting for the Oberkommando West Deutschland, the Panzergrenadier Division Feldherrnhalle. Versus in the west, we got Job fighting for the Soviet Union and the 2nd Guards Mechanized Corps. We've got here Scavenge, Elite Armored and Special Operations with Infantry Bulletins, including Jaegers, versus Soviet Industry, Mechanized Support and Guard Motor with Infantry and Machine Gun Bulletins here for Jove, noting about a special rifle command start with a sniper they are versus Jesslyn with double full scan of these. He's also playing it aggressively his Sturm Pioneers, so they're trying to disrupt his opponent's early game, which with a sniper start there could slightly work, but of course will run into a particularly pointed problem as people's brains start getting splattered across the ground. My god, Jürgen's brains! Sit all over me! I never get a stench off me! Sandbags up here. Points they've been grabbed. We got a scout crane on the way for Joe. So Joe opening up here with some very aggressive mobile gameplay there versus Jesslyn. Whereas Jesslyn is just sort of flooding the field with infantry, which certainly makes it harder for the snipers to do anything. While Joe, in the meanwhile, of course, then sort of starts just to catch control as well. So Jesslyn can just sort of slowly move ahead here. Though, of course, on sort of single engagements, he might run into a few problems. Sort of slightly poking his head in and out here. Probably sort of trying to suss out the sniper, at least keep him occupied there. Third squad there arriving for Jesslyn. The Panzergrenadier Division Feldherrnhalle was formed out of what remained of the SA after most of it had been sort of dissolved and stuffed into the SS. There was also a Panzer Brigade Feldherrnhalle, which fought mostly on the Western Front, if not exclusive. There was the Panzergrenadier Division Feldherrnhalle, later Panzer Division, and then finally Panzer Corps fought exclusively on the Eastern Front. A bit, I think, up in the Baltics, then largely, I think it was sort of Hungary until it was sort of wrecked in the siege of Budapest, which I really wish Relic would have tried to visit with companies too, one way or the other. And then I don't know quite where the Panzer Corps itself fought. There's some small details there. Volkswagen still pushing towards the center. Scout car here with engineer support engaging here, sort of ensuring here that Jesslyn can't grab the fuel point. Sniper conscious moving in there. Good job here with the conscious. That should help screen the snipers a bit, making it harder here for Jesslyn to sort of just rush the snipers for some Sturm Pioneers. So good work there. Scout coming up here, flanking in from the south. There we go. Falls will push back, and there we go. Jesslyn's assault broken off with severe casualties. Meanwhile, Joe following up here in the morning, finishing to try and blunt Jesslyn's spearhead here. So Falls going to do smelling about a bit. The Panzergrenadier Division Feldherrnhalle, by the way, was actually a surprisingly well-equipped Panzergrenadier Division, I believe, with actual half-tracks, which was surprisingly rare for a Panzergrenadier Division, which was pretty much mostly truck-borne, and actual Panzers. It actually, I think, got a full Panther Battalion, plus a tank destroyer battalion, a couple of Jagdpanzers, and might even gotten Stugs, though I'm less sure about that one. Well, that tended to be rather rare, since Panzergrenadier Divisions was mostly just truck infantry with a single battalion of Stugs, in most cases, maybe some Jagdpanzers of the less upgraded kind. But Volks is then moving about here, back here, troops in reinforcing, Bell Group Headquarters going up for Jesslyn. I would have figured, you know, maybe a Bell Mechanized Regiment, always more popular or useful with the looks, but still, Bell Group Headquarters is surprisingly useful, probably for the healing, though it is rather expensive. Conscript grabbing about there, scout can hang back there, the M301 provided by the Americans via Lend-Lease, usually handed out to reconnaissance units, sort of their push forwards, rapidly grab points. The Rota Razvedki or something like that, which is sort of a reconnaissance unit which sort of worked by rushing it, securing a vital point until sort of the main force could arrive. Which is supposed to have got here going for the 2nd Guards Mechanized, sort of an advanced guard here, which the Feldherrnhalle is sort of trying to push away before the rest of the corps arrives. Volkswagen is here, Panzer fighting in the scout car, damaged engine. Sturm Pioneers taking a few hits, the scout car pulling back there, 50 caliber raking away at the Germans. Snipers laying down a few more hits there. 8 kills.
The enemy is taking what we have secured.
Volkswagen in a trouble. And I think thematically it would have been more interesting if they actually gone for something like that rather than the penal battalion. You left the penal battalion sort of more, well, a doctrinal unit than sort of create sort of a reconnaissance infantry unit there. But oh well. in the south and east of Kremlin territory. Jeslin, though, still pushing his hands. He's actually lost a Storm Pioneer score. That's pretty terrible there for Jeslin in the early game. Though we are seeing a few assault mobs that are being hit up to the Fulks. Gonna need to see if Fulks is running to chop here with the scout car. Rear mounted 30 caliber there, gunning them down a bit. Closing an invention to one, but the loss of that Storm Pioneer score will hurt Jeslin. It's going to make it hard for him, for example, then, of course, to sort of fight and repair vehicles. Briefly consider the light infantry gun, but versus this kind of build here, a lot of conscript, scout cars, and sniper, the light infantry gun I think will be of less use. Oh, he's going for the flak half track. That's not necessarily something I'd recommend either, but Jeslin is nonetheless going forward. If you've got the first doctoral choice here, it is Scout Motor for Job. Ever popular, ever potent. Of course, the fun thing to note is the heavy mortar's rather dropped off in uses. I mean, it's a pretty still good mortar, but most people just go for the regular mortar. I know mortars all just rely on the guardsmen. Sturm Puny on the way there. Sandbags being laid up here. Pretty good position. Can be used to hold the point. Also to guard the area here. Also be used against the building. Of course, it can be used by the enemy, but they can't sort of contest the point at the same time. Medics on the way there for Jeslin and the Feldherrn Harlot. Flak half track arrives. This variant was, I think, actually not really produced a lot, but I think it was only for the Falchion Panzer Grenadier Division. Hermann Göring, sort of a more specific sort of field modification. The sort of more factory produced ones didn't quite have that sort of full setup there. But well, more sandbags here. Actually, we can sort of see Job setting up sort of a prepared positions. A lot of sandbags, overlapping sandbags too. That's actually pretty interesting. They're not bad there by Job. I mean, a lot of players tend to neglect sandbags overall, but Job is clearly sort of special setup a bit battlefield prepared there for Jeslin, though. Looks like he wasn't quite prepared for the flat half track, which is sort of rare, so not too hard there to be surprised at that one. There you go, blitzing it forwards. Fault's going to be Storm Puny as supporting. Job here could consider taking up, but there goes Skarka going in there with full of guardsmen, flanking the flat half track. That's pretty bad there. He needs to get it away. He keeps firing. Might actually work out here in this case. Job might have underestimated Jeslin's tenacity. Oh yeah, he pops back, but oh, incendiary grenade, and the flak half track goes down. I mean, that was pretty much a win there for Jove. I mean, that flak half track, they really did not cost the same as that one of the guardsmen losses. They don't really sort of factor into it either. I mean, the flak half track doesn't really do enough damage and is not survivable enough. It's, I think, really sort of, you know, pay, make it sort of worth 55 fuel. That's a bit the problem with it. It's just a bit too much price for what you're getting at the moment. I mean, you'd say like 35 fuel, it could work. But 55 fuel, yeah, I wouldn't recommend it, personally. Jeslin here going for scavenge, the ever popular scavenge choice there for the Orbital Commander Vest at the moment. Office Jaegers, grenades, thorough salvage, and of course the ever, you know, useful call-in a light or some kind of armor nest to keep the enemy occupied and things, in case things go pear-shaped. And again, the Austrian in that department tends to work pretty decently because you don't have to tech for it. But there you go, Jaegers out here supporting. There were actual Jaegers fighting on the Eastern Front compared to in the Western Front. Well, there really weren't any Jaegers, but on the Eastern Front there were plenty sort of larger Jaeger divisions. Sort of meant for fighting in slightly rougher terrain. There were lighter divisions, meaning they didn't have a lot of sort of heavier weaponry, not a lot of, for example, artillery of the heavier kind. Little fun fact there. I mean, generally don't hear much about the Jaegers either. Snarba there versus Sturm Pioneer. Down here, troops on the way back for healing reinforcement. Jaegers going points here. Of course, he could consider laying down some booby traps, and the Germans were quite fond of booby trapping things. By the way, you can read entire books on that. Grenadiers ready. And some of them were quite inventive. And of course, the funny thing is, the way mines are generally used in this game tends to be more like the booby trap principle. You sort of just lay something there, rather than just an entire minefield's worth of them. Sort of the funny thing. Except for the Wehrmacht, who doesn't get that sort of ability. But there you go, second Jaeger unit here for Jeslin. A few in manpower, they're also a reasonably cheap unit. They can have a surprisingly large effect on the enemy, so I mean, they generally tend to be sort of decent choices as long as you don't overdo them and don't play them like complete pats. But we can see Job now's really gone for a lot of infantry. Two guard squads, three conscripts, plus the sniper here. Jester still trying to turn the tables over. The Jaeger still trying to bleed out his opponent. Steel punch across. There we go. We got Jaeger's flanking. We got a sprint there. Nice work. Nice sprint there. We meanwhile here in the center. Jesslyn's forces pushing forwards there. Getting Joe's forces running there. In the south, fuel pumping is caught by engineers in here. Reinforcement healing going on. Will Jesslyn try and take up? Will he go for light vehicles? We'll try and aim for orbital Darden and some medium panzers. Deep up the single number for Jove's guardsmen, increasing their firepower here. I think at this point, Jove might want to consider heavy mortar. I think that would help a bit there versus some of Jesslyn's forces in some of his play there. Just a thought, anyways. Well, it's surprising how few people actually go for it at the moment. But there you go, taking up for Jesslyn. Will it be mechanized? Will it be Schwer Panzered Quarters? Time will tell. As for Jove, he could take up right now. Maybe sort of try and push out a light tank there versus Jesslyn. T-70, could go for the half tracks. That could also be helpful. Well, an SU-76 then. We'll of course have to see what it is it goes for. But so far, there's just nothing really there from Jove. Small push towards the south. And a bit worse to the center as well. Guardsman Conscript, their force is hiding out here behind the bushes, ready to, you know, unleash hell up close. There you go, Guardsman caught here as they sort of walk straight into it. Grenadiers, oh, there we go, grenade off from the Guardsman. There we go, the Guardsman end up retreating as the Falkers push in there. Good move there by Jesslyn. Sniper sneaking up here with the sniper rifles and closing in there. 21 kills. That sniper team has paid off, I think, quite nicely there for Jove so far. 21 kills against the Orbital Commander Vest. Take up there for Jesslyn. Schwer Panzered Quarters. That could be an Orbital Darden. Panzers. And the other stuff there. That's, of course, it covers his fuel point. Again, the altar tends to be a benefit. Meanwhile, Jove is also taking up the Tank of Tank Command there. In the south here, Folter is going points. And here, Gaspin continues to kill. Also noting here, he's actually using conscripts to merge with them, keeping down the reinforcement course a bit on the Guardsman. Though the conscript sort of recruits there are a bit easier to kill, but overall they'll still have the same DPS as the Guardsmen, and overall just sort of serves as bodies, so it'll work out in most cases. Unless you're playing that complete recklessly. Alternate Bart Y, in fact, he's laying down an awful lot of Bart Y here to make it harder for Jove to move through the east. Interesting sort of modification over the battlefield there by Jesslyn. Nice to see. Jaeger Sith versus Guardsmen, he's great assault there. Got a steel hand grenade. Getting a few guard kills there. The Germans did also have another grenade here called the Aya Granato, Aya sort of egg grenade, since it was rather egg shaped. But it's not quite as iconic, really. The steel hand grenade, which is more iconic, of course, World War One was sort of had the advantage due to the stick. You could throw it longer, though, of course, the opponent could throw it back. On the other hand, it did have a less explosive power and really didn't have much fragmentation power, which they did add to sort of add a sleeve for to sort of add fragmentation power. But sort of little fun facts there. Grenade going up against the Guardsmen. Falkner's pushing through here against the conscripts up close. Pushing them back. Nice flank there, but in this case, hold it by what looks like a mine and some conscripts. SU-6 there for Jesslyn. Not Jesslyn, but Joe. So bringing up a light assault gun. He's worried about Jesslyn bringing up armor, it would seem. He's not so much worried about the infantry at the moment. More about light vehicles and such. So we got an assault gun out there for Jove. Jump on here versus conscripts. Troops being pushed back there. Around the center, folks can lose creeping about. Another grenade assault here.
Jürgen, why did you hit the house? Sorry, this is my first time. We didn't have time in boot camp for it. Ah, you idiot.
Technically, in many cases, the German troops that sort of arrived to the division would usually have been put through a sort of bit of a unique concept to the German army, which is known as the training and replacement battalion, which most divisions, particularly the elite ones, had, meaning any recruits there would have been sort of acclimatized, sort of trained a bit further up there by division veterans. It's one of those fun concepts which generally don't see a lot of sort of talking about. Jocelyn here going for the Flakpanzer, Ostwind. Surprisingly, no represented, I think, in the game compared to any other German Flakpanzer. Then again, Flakpanzers generally tend always to get overrepresented, despite, you know, well, anti-aircraft tanks. There generally not being that many of them. A bit more, you know, sexy and interesting than, you know, a half track with an anti-aircraft gun on it. But there goes moving up. Getting the guards who are caught on the wrong side of the cover, and a huge hit there, wiping four men with one hit of the third sermon of the flak. Quick grenade against Jaeger's flak moving up there as well. Hitting a car several times. Ludwig, it's a car! There's no Russians in it. I just don't like the model. I hate it. Terrible design. And not German. Could you save the nationalism for another time? Shoot the Russians! Close veterans one year in the SM6. Sniper there, 23 kills, 22 up north, Fulton versus conscripts. Joe certainly struck me a bit here versus Jesslyn at the moment, also noting longer match and mid game analysis. I don't think Joe should consider some deeper flanks there versus Jesslyn, and I think, you know, more through the south as well. It's sort of a neglected path there. Oh, grenade assault against the conscripts. Mostly harmless there in this case. SM6, they're almost ready to lay down a close quarters murder barrage. Here, conscripts just need to retreat before they annihilate. And there we go. Joe is now going for the T-70 light tank. I think he should have gone for that first. There you go. Getting poor Lutnik killed. And also here supporting Sturm Pilot Squad, Volkskunde Squad. Mr. Sig moving in, but there might be something in the way. There you go. Volkskunde is with a Panzerfaust. Damaging the engineer of the SM6. T-70 almost done there for Jove. Jesslyn is slowly taking up towards something, saving up for something. Maybe some Orbital Darden, maybe a Panzer IV Panther. Could also be a Yak Panzer, though the Yak Panzer is not exactly what you'd call popular currently. For reasons that are hard to blame it for. Also, there's a T-70. Osprey flying away there. Jaeger's Volkskunde Sturm Pioneer is a sizable force assembled by Jesslyn to push forwards and reclaim the territory for the Reich.
SU-76, go ahead.
Now he might want to be careful, that's just going to be it. Yeah, looks like he's setting up for something here, maybe a slight flank.
Territory secured. You need light anti-tank support?
Ah, Joe is shifting out there. Really would benefit from a heavy mortar to cover some of all this estate. We got the support from company here. Not a bad choice either. Regular mortar could also do the trick, maybe a Maxim. T-70 light tank that arrives there for Job. Here points are being grabbed up north as well. Sandbags going down there. Rule, good work there by Job to try and make it harder here there for Jesslyn to push him off any of the points. M6 moving up. He might want support with the T-70 to help deal with infantry. Set the T-70, Job. The north country as well. Finally, ultimately pushed back here by Jesslyn's forces. Jaeger's pushed back, the T-70 moving in, but in this case a bit too late. Contrast sneak a bit back in the south, good work. Good work. And there going the centre, double gas from there, repulsing the Volkskunde assault here as well. Volks is halted by the T-70. Field gun on the way there for Joe. Again, he's worried about enemy armour. Conscripts push back there. Closing in on Retchen 2-1. Jesslyn seems to be controlling himself a bit, not just calling in another Austin, which is a popular choice for the many Overcommand West players. Just spamming Austin's even when it doesn't make any sense. T-70, SM6, they're sort of preparing more for sort of defense of the south and north. We got a bit of movement here as well. He could actually try and make a push here for the Schwerpanzer quarters. Of course, he doesn't. I think they're thinking us. He knows it's there yet. Otherwise, he could make some bigger moves here for the SM6. The field guns will try and destroy it before he can bring up anything from it. T-70 engaged with the Ostwind. A few hits there. Sensor engagement here. T-70 here would actually, I think, be quite helpful versus all of the distant troops there. And up here, Conscript versus Vulcan is the folks that got the upper hand there thanks to the assault rifles. And we actually got a Yak Panzer there for Jesslyn. He's clearly taking, I think, the threat there of Jove's armor a bit seriously. Trying to go for a Yak Panzer, or does he have something else planned? But a Yak Panzer, a very rare sight on the battlefields at the moment. Though, of course, the official or actual designation is Panzer 470. In this case, V. For Walmart, which was the manufacturer there. It was never actually really called a Yak Panzer. The again, official designation was just Panzer 4-70, which I think was sort of a measure to try and fool the Allies to think they actually upgraded it with a gun like that. In actuality, a Panzer 4 with that kind of gun would not have been able to use it very well. I mean, if it wouldn't just, you know, tumble over, just blow off the gun or turret clean off when it fired, I mean, it'd have a very hard time actually aiming with it. It would solve a bit the same issue of the Firefly. If not worse, actually, in terms of accuracy as well. The Russians ran into some of the same issues when they, for example, tried to upgun the T-34 even further, I think, with a 100mm gun. It was basically impossible to sort of hit anything with it properly. There you go, tank destroyer out. Shoots, misses. Garten flying away there merrily with a deep lock machine gun. Oh! Dieter down. Osman bring up support here. Cover shattered. Garten need to go out there quickly. Osman taking up support here. Quick shot there against the Osman and misses. Misses again. There you go, Lancer hit there with the assault gun up north. They've got some minor engagement here, cutting the wire. Good, but halted by the Fulton Grenadiers. T-70 repairing itself, coming under fire here from the... Oh, good hits there on this Yak Panzer by, I think, the field gun. Two field guns, actually, an SM-6 now. Jove is quickly gunning out there to deal with Jesslyn's armored threats. There you go, Fulton is under fire from the assault gun. And Vetchny 2, 4 kills. Silly barrage. Oh, right on the base! Naughty! Light infantry gone away, so now Jesslyn's actually adding artillery rounds. Again, Jove is just sort of relying on his MSN6, possibly his field guns, but that's what, otherwise, not really a lot of artillery, and he's certainly not laid down a lot of mines either. Here, there's his opponent. We got here barbed wire being sort of tried to be dealt with here by the guardsman. That's going to be rather long and arduous. Also note, he continues to merge here with his guard squads. If not a lot, just a bit there. Thirty-four kills, better fever. There you go. Massive into push here from Jesslyn. Almost catching. Oh, good lord. Almost got the sniper there. Bold attempt there by Jesslyn. And overwrought any machine guns or any sort of scissor to there from Joe. There's not really much there to punish that move up north. Here we got Fox, there's the guardsman, we got the T-7 supporting as well. Falcon of these Jaegers pushing in straight into two conscript squads there. SN6 ready to support. And we got a bombardment there. Oh dear. That could almost have been brought for Jesslyn. Yak Panzer moving in. No further take up there from Joe. He's going to planning more SN6s, T-70s, half-jacks. Grenade assault there against the Guardsman. No, by the way, they finally managed to clear it up, but now the house is gone, meaning that was just kind of wasted effort. Quick hit there on the Yak Panzer with a field gun, penetrating the frontal armor. Over there pushing forwards against Jesslyn, taking a few hits here from the Ostwind and the light infantry gun there, like this Infanterie Schutz. T-70 creeping about. Yak Panzer shoots but misses. Of course, one of the hallmarks of the high velocity gun here was, in fact, it was really accurate due to the sheer velocity, meaning the shot was just getting. Didn't really deviate a lot before, you know, longer up. I mean, he also had a really flat trajectory. So that made it, you know, again, very accurate. Of course, same with the Panther. The Yak Panther did have a few issues since the gun, even then, when the sort of mounting on an assault gun, seeing no casemate, it was still kind of too heavy and had issues with, for example, the gun sticking into the dirt, which would cause some pretty big problems. Another fun fact is, usually that'd be sort of like, you know, a muscle here, muscle breaks, you know, cover things up. But the problem was, if they used it on the Yak Panther, it'd simply kick up so much dirt that A, give them away, and B, they wouldn't be able to see anything. So, a very common modification was to basically remove the muscle brake on the thing. Little fun fact there as well.
Brave infantry have made the ultimate
losses
sacrifice.
There for Jove. Looks like a conscript squad bit the dust in service of the motherland.
Encroaching on our territory.
We got a mechanized armor company there for Jove. Could bring up T-35s. I still think you should go for a mortar at the very least.
Our headquarters is Yak Panther
shoots. Gets a hit. Issue 6 shoots. Does not get a hit. So what is Jesslyn planning next? Panther Fort? Panther? Is that aiming for a King Tiger now? I mean, he's actually got some armor, some infantry, so it wouldn't be a complete, you know, terrible idea to now aim for a King Tiger, since again, he's got something that can contest the field and actually deal with armor. Though, of course, he could always still just push for more armor, sort of more medium armor. But ultimately, that, of course, is Jesslyn's decision. Yeah, of course, we're not the conscripts.
Capturing supply sector.
Veterancy 2, meaning high rate of fire there. Murdering Yuri and Vasily, and we got a truck there on the way for Jesslyn. That's probably going to make a nice regiment, which again could lend further credence to the D's aim for the King Tiger. Jove, they're bringing up a T-30-45. Bring up a bigger tank. T-10 moving in, closing in on T2. But in this case, running straight, so Folt's going to be waiting with the Panther Fires. Yak Panther moving up. Veterancy 2 there, though, we've got a field gun covering. There you go, field gets a hit. Yak Panther shoots, lands Veterancy 1. Using the house here to cover it against Yak Panther. But no, he shoots through it and gets the T-70. Nice work there by Jesslyn, destroying Jove's light tank up north. Jaegers versus Folt's going to be the consequence here. Molotovs here, I think, would have been helpful. Instead, we got a grenade assault there from Jesslyn against Jove's conscripts. T-35 there arriving for Jove and the motherland. Also planning support here, Jaegers retreating, but the conscripts ultimately have to retreat as well in the face of bigger force. Interesting to notice, Jove isn't really trying much through here. Again, he's sort of focused on pushing through in the center and then slightly in the north, but even then, it's not really big pushes. I mean, at this point, it might be an idea for Jove to reconsider his tactics and strategy, because again, it's very much just trying to secure the center and then, you know, neglecting the rest of the map there. Whereas Jesslyn does seem to be displaying a bit more alacrity in Sudan, saying that, but at the same time, though, he could also be doing a lot more in the south. I mean, he could try and push harder for Joe's fuel point, which he isn't at the moment. Grenade flashing out the folks with their T-34 flanking and breaking the cover there with the T-5 and a gun. Yak Panther takes it from the field gun. Still rain down the Gart. Another hit down the T-35. Close to a T-2 in the south. There we got Volkswagen's Jaegers and an Ostwind. Breaking open Jesslyn south. At, no, no, Jove south. Jove, though, assault going here from the north, going for the victory point there. Good work there. Quickly hiding away the tank destroyer there. Gartman being attacked by Fulton is quickly retreating. T-35 needs repairs, got the objective moving up. We could actually use self-repair. Right now, Jove is floating an awful lot of munitions. Awful lot. So they find there. SM6, they're not really hitting a lot.
300 points.
T-34-76 now on the way for Jove. Bit of cheaper medium armor. That's also a bit faster out, Leslie. They've actually got the resources now to go for the T-35, so I mean, he could cancel it instead, aim for that. That's ultimately his own decision. Defense of the north here with the Falkland and his Jaegers, and of course the Ostwind. The Ostwind orbits on the point here to try and stall and delay Joe. Field gun bombarding now. So again, he's relying pretty much on his field gun and assault gun for artillery there against Jesslyn. T-34-76 arriving. T-34 almost done. Nice flank there by Jessen, actually getting behind here. Jove's northern push.
Supply sector under attack.
In the center, Jessen controlling the south. Jessen also grabbing points there. Now we've got one tank supporting the northern infantry. Good work. The T-3045 has been repaired. Here, Falcon is behind the wreckage of a T-70, taking heavy hits there from the guardsmen before finally being pushed back. T-76 slowly advancing. And another push for the center, supported here by the assault gun. The T-35 not really doing anything there. And there you go, Yak Panzer shoots to the assault gun. Assault gun needs to pull back. Guardsmen supporting, cutting apart the rush German infantry. There you go, grenade off. Oh, straight into it. Forced retreat there. In the south, T-55 moving in here to deal with the Jaegers. And there you go. Here's the engine of the tank before just breaking into a retreat. Good work there. Troops are healing, reinforcing, moving out again. Again, I'm surprised Joe had not brought up any artillery. Again, a heavy mortar, I think, would actually allow him to at least sort of suppress the light infantry gun a bit by just bombarding it from a safer range and a distance. T-56 was not supporting the conscripts there, meaning now they're on their own against the Ostman and the Sturmpioneers. Let's grant in the south. Assault gun moving in support from the T-35 to have a hitch of mine, damaging its engines. Now he's moving the T-34-76 there. Taking a bit of a while there. And Sturmpioneers quickly sent scurrying back. Holmes got the task wiped. He's really going for the wipe there. And there we go, got it off, but needs to retreat here before the Jagdpanzer engages, and there it goes, shoots. Folks are close to being wiped out. In the north, the T-34-76 here trying to escape the deadly shot of the Jagdpanzer. There we go, cutting, rushing in. Problem is that the Schwer Panzer Corps is quickly suppressing them, but the T-34-76 does escape. Falkland is barely survived the encounter, and the south Jaeger sent running again. So a lot of action here across the map, though again, mostly centered, well, around the center of the map, not so much the north or the south here. Veterans, 3 Jaegers, 10 kills. Sniper, by the way, is dead. That was probably lost somewhere in all the action. I mean, got more engineers there to help speed up repairs of tanks. I mean, Jove could also consider Katyusha trying to again silence the enemy artillery goals just to do more damage to Jessen in that way, maybe break up some of his attacks. And Jessen is just slowly now aiming for the King Tiger, the Königstiger. Ooh, right, the Falcon Discord. On retreat, veterinary fired with assault rifles. That's going to hurt Jessen quite a bit there. There we go, Jagdpanzer arrives, shoots and misses. T-34-76 being self-repaired. Up here, Conscript versus Jaegers. Incendiary grenade here really would help him. Instead, we got a grenade assault there from... easily dodged here. Meaning the Conscript now have the advantage there over the Jaegers, because, in fact, they took a few shots there instead of throwing the grenades. And, of course, once more, the Ostman arrives to save the day here. Joe holding back there against Jesslin and the Panzergrenadier Division Schoenfeldherrnhalle. Got demo charge in front of it. That's definitely one way of doing it. I think you should lay down more mines in the south. We got another demo charge there. Risky demo charge set up there, since there's so much artillery rain down around the area, it could actually be accidentally set off there. Oh, hit another mine there. Now the tank there with the damage engine for Jove. Jessen's Jagdpanzer going in there for the kill. If he were to try and sort of support it here, he might be able to flank the Jagdpanzer and deal with it. In fact, right now, if he were to just try and rush the Jagdpanzer, he could probably do it. I mean, he's got more tanks plus the assault gun and the field guns. I mean, if Jove were to push in now, he could probably do it. Oh, never mind. It's too late now because the King Tigers were up. There was actually, I think, that window for Jove. He could have done it, but just sort of held back there against Jesslin. Possibly warrant that Jessen actually had Academy efforts. That's the thing, Jessen's got no Academy efforts. No one to take. besides the Yak Panther for a brief period of time, then my apologies for that sneeze. But we've got the King Tiger out here, Koenigsegger. Close here. I mean, he could try and lure it onto the demo chart, then might work. But there you go, Fjellgren's firing at the Yak Panther. Jaeger's pushing forward, so another bit of the fleet squad here. Also firing that some Northern Conscripts, King Tiger moving ahead there. High velocity, 88 mil gun flying away there. Does really get a good hit there against the Guardsman. Now it's basically when things get more difficult here for Joe, because he wasn't really able to punish Jesslyn again while he was just relying on a single Yak Panther, probably because again he wasn't quite aware of it, otherwise I do think Joe would have played a lot more aggressively versus him. But I think an actually fire right now is going to be necessary to help deal with the King Tiger there for Joe. I mean, he could in theory go for more SU-76s, but I think SU-5 is going to lose the choice due to its high penetration and accuracy. Jesslyn meanwhile pushing it pretty confidently there with his heavy armour and medium. Fixing up the T-30-35. Jesslyn's actually not got a lot of map there, though of course it does a lot of armor. Infantry-wise, it's a bit more limited as well. Jaeger's moving ahead here, but they were to step close enough to the demo. Ooh, right there, but he's got to pay attention, I don't think so. And I mean, he could set it off here, but it's not quite going to... right now would be absolutely, I think, almost golden there for a demo chance set off. Just a bit of extra luck there. A bit of extra work, so trying to get them to come together around it. Set it off, there we go. Jaeger's almost wiped. King Tiger takes a bit of damage there. Osmond almost fit into the Yak Panther as well here. Constantly need to fall back before they're annihilated here. In the center, King Tiger falls back, not really much engaged there. Got the figure being pushed forward, but I think that's a bit too late there by Joe. But now he is swarming forth, surging forwards into the centre of the map there to reclaim it from the fascists. And Gossman straight into the field guns here, need to be careful with that one. Several hits there landing on it, taking it almost out there. And there you go, the Osman is kaput. He had served so well there for Jesslyn and the Felton Halley, but was ultimately taken out in a matter of moments when things really came down to it. Yak Panther blitzing forwards there, looking for some few easy kills, but sadly there is nothing for it to shoot at, and ultimately there ends up being a waste of fuel. Artillery though raining down again. Another barrage there from the Leichtes Feldhaubitzen. But he looks like he's going to take some shots here at the Jove's armor inside his own base. The bold aggressive play there with Jesslyn, Yak Panther in this case making use of the Yak Jaeger sort of spot ahead there, which does make sense. Getting a few hits there, very close to veteran free, one more hit and cooks up the SU-6 there, ammo blown up, which then gives it more movement and rate of fire. There you go, T-34's in the tight flanks, but instead runs into the King Tiger. Yak Panther misses, King Tiger by a miss as well. There you go, lands a hit there. Yak Panther does as well now. Half eight of T-4, summoning here the Austin for fuel and munitions. Conscript charging forwards in the south here. Fulton versus Guard, but the Guard looks like they're winning out that one. Jove has yet to bring up any issue. Fun fact, he's beginning to float quite a bit of fuel. Yeah, it's not good for him then. It's on the other hand good for Jesslyn. Oh, nice hit there from the field gun, wiping out a large chunk there of the Volksgrenadiers. Jaeger's pushing forwards, and there go another grenade assault. Jesslyn's men have clearly been equipped heavily with grenades for this assault against the Russians' positions to take them back. And there you go, SU-5 tanks are on the way for Jove. It would later be replaced by the SU-100, though that was late 1945, sort of at least for World War II there. So around, I think, roughly February, March it sort of hit. But it actually suffered some of the same issues with the Yak Panther, that is, the gun was too big. Womp. But I was actually same sort of a bit the same history again based on the chassis of the main tank there, Panzer IV, and the Yak Panzer T-34 there for the SU-185 and 100. And also just like the, you know, SU 100, you know, was based in Nation 5. Also, there means so was the Yak Panzer based on some of the regular Yak Panzer initially as well. So, some fun facts there. Fun facts. But there you go, SU 85 out there for Jove. Will this help break through the fascist lines? Jaeger's losing up to the Guardsmen. They do hit better than before. Again, actually, we can see now Jason Hector building up a severe artillery advantage as again. Jove never really sort of went for a lot of it, and I'm a bit surprised again. There's no regular mortars or heavy mortars. I think they're going to help a lot, in particular on the defence there against Jeslin. Would have made it a lot harder there for Jeslin to use cover and just sort of advance out in the open. Plus, again, I mean, smoke machine should also help for this, for example, rush the Yak Panzer. There goes Stukas of us. Six rockets with explosive death unleashed against Jove's lines. Gets a few kills, but mostly damage against the Special Rifle Command. Comes out in the open, take fire there. Falkskirs moving up with their assault rifles. Field gun trying to sneak up. Asian firing up through the center. Yak Panzer firing away here. Vetsy feet so close to Vetsy 4 and increased rate of fire and accuracy. There you go, lands a hit on the Asian 5. Yes, Asian 5 shoots back, misses. Yak Panzer lands another hit, and there you go, hits Vetsy 5, almost ace level. Defender 5 there almost fixed up. King Tiger slowly milling about in the south. Jaeger's grabbing points there. T-34-76 sneaking about, and there we go. We got another two barrage out there from Jeslin. Probably around here, Joe's base. Again. There we go. T-34-6 engaged by the Yak Panzer. Needs to be careful with that. Another hit, down to half health. High rate of fire on that. He's actually going to get it. He's going to get it there, Joe. Underestimating it, perhaps, either way, that T-34 is kaput. Yak Panzer on the other end, it's halfway to Vetsy 5. Bad news there for Jove. I mean, the Yak Panzer early on can generally be dealt with reasonably easy if you just sort of rush it. The problem is, once it sort of hits enough Vetsy, it becomes quite the little beast. Because right now, again, it has a high rate of fire, can camouflage, got good mobility, decent frontal armor, decent health. And that Vetsy 5 gets even better bonus there out of camouflage, but he can actually land some pretty nasty first hits. And then follow up with more regular hits at quite a nasty pace. King Tiger Vetsy 1. Yak Panzer shoots again, another hit then the Vetsy 5. Takes a hit that the Vetsy 5 bounces off the Yak Panzer's armor. 80mm of sloped armor, the Vetsy 5 and only had 45mm of sloped armor. Jaeger's still rushing the field gun. Whoops. Got the field gun. Bad news for Jove again. I mean, he's trying to engage Jeslin too much head on, winning in. That's really what the Yak Panzer want you to do. What the Yak Panzer does not want you to do is flank it. So far, Jove hasn't really been doing much of that. But yeah, Jeslin is enjoying overwhelming armor superiority and artillery advantage. Infantry wise, Jove does have an heads up there, but bullet artillery plus the King Tiger, it's going to struggle a bit there, to put it mildly. Defender moving up, super close to Vetsy 2. Guardsman taking losses there out in the open. Field gun shoots, lands a hit there against Jeslin's Königsieger. Got John Pioneers on the way there for Jeslin, the interesting position now. And also, I think he's third to the Umpani squad. Another hit there from the field gun. King Tiger close to half health. Obviously, he might want to rest the northern victory point a bit more there, Mr. Jove. Another hit there from the Yak Panzer. So close to 55, and there you go. Now it is an ace level Yak Panzer. It's that, Helmut. We're heroes. Yeah. Except we've only blown up one tank. Details, details. It's the Russians. There'll be plenty of opportunities to blow them up. Another T-34 down the way for Joe. T-34-76. Interesting. And the south points they're being grabbed.
Only 200 points remain. Double your efforts.
Yes, comrade?
But certainly looking a bit grim here for Joe and the second guards. A bit too many head-on assaults, not enough flanking, and certainly a lack of artillery, I think, has rather given Jesslyn numerous hands up there. And now he's sort of got a lot of, you know, veteran troops and armor. More artillery fire there. Gets a few more kills, but nothing too catastrophic there against Job this time around.
The enemy has cut off a sector.
Demo charge still there. Jesslyn's not really made any moves for that. Eventually, two for the T-35. Looks like he's planning something up north against Joe or Jesslyn. Could it be he's actually planning to flank? Also, a ton of munitions. Big fat ton. Now, the T-34-76 looks like he's really planning to sort of hit Jesslyn with as many tanks as possible. That way, just flooding him with numbers, which might make it harder here for the Yak Panther and the King Tao to deal with him, though. In this case, a veteran fire would be sort of less worried by it than, say, a veteran to naught. Again, due to the sheer high rate of fire plus extra mobility and armor. Meaning you really need to catch it off guard right away, otherwise the Yak Panther's going to quickly do a lot of damage to you. Guarding the south a bit here. King Tiger shoots, misses. Seems. North there, Foxman, those are the engineers and the T-35. King Tiger sneaks in there, go unlinked to the line of fire, the H-5. Shot bounces, guardsman shoots, that obviously bounces. Penetrating hit. Shot bounces.
The enemy has taken our supply sector.
In the south, Conscripts versus Sturm Pioneers. Tanks have been held in reserve there. Is he planning a third, another tank there? Maybe another H-5. I mean, double H-5 should certainly be quite effective there versus the King Tiger, and even slightly help versus the Yak Panzer. More chili fire there. Doesn't do any damage there, though, really, against Jove. Looks like one T-34-76 being dispatched to the north. We got another one away there. He's really preparing there for a big all-in assault there with his tanks against Jesslyn. This is going to be tricky there. It's going to be really tricky. But if he pulls it off correctly, he could do a lot of damage there to Jesslyn. A lot. But it also depends on then sort of supporting the all-in armored assault with an infantry and field gun. Sort of keep pace there. Sort of quickly crawl to the ground. Osman out there for Jesslyn, Flak Panzer number 2. But yeah, Job is setting up for something big here.
There are no cowards here. Area secured.
The North King Tiger gaining the engineers. Osman moving up as well to support. I think Jesslyn sensing something's going to happen soon. He's just not entirely sure what it's and where it's coming from. Panzer versus false grenadiers. Alright, we got tanks setting up there. H-5, also moving out. Alrighty. Summer tank from the front. Flanking elements get going there, though of course we have to worry about the mines here that can cause some problems. Troops having he's using it, he makes the first to draw the fire there, moving in the tanks, one mine hit off there. It's the 76 that are taking it, need to get the 85 moving there, flank the King Tiger, mark it. There we go, Yak Panzer, the H-5 firing away there, taking hits from the Yak Panzer. Almost got the King Tiger there, almost down, there we go. Continuing here, Yak Panzer seems to be the next target. Not a lot of shots hitting though in the move, exposing his armor there to a lot of other things. Almost got it though, almost. But again, the sheer speed here makes it a lot harder to catch up with. Plus, when he drives into the base there, I mean, he gets close to the Panther first. Of course, the question is, maybe he should have just pulled back here and sort of tried to draw it out again, having been satisfied with the loss of the King Tiger. Instead, he's now losing at least one tank here, another one quickly following up here. And we got the Osvin, moving up the issue 5 to try and catch the Yak Panzer. Ah, hits a wreck instead. Got the Stukas of Fuss. Now they hit, they almost got the Jagdpanzer. Need to pull back here, need to pull back. Now push your luck, Joe. Don't push your luck. T-34 fixed up. Lost the H-25 there. It's a single ambush shot. There's some sort of damage. Right there again, I think Joe should have just pulled back and begun securing, consolidating all his territorial gains and also bring up more armor. It's another mine, heavy engine damage. Right against another ambush shot there. Trying to ram it, but he's taking a lot of damage. Just barely ran out. They got knocked out there again. Joe really putting in everything, but he's now lost a lot of equipment just to try and take out this Jagdpanzer at Veteran 25. Which, as you might note, is quite potent. But again, Joe had been feeding that thing all game long, and now it came to bite him in the arse. Even as then proceeded to feed it even more. A lot of salvage there as well. Again, I think he's just sort of called it off there. Just began securing a lot of territory, then tried to draw it in, then launch another flank. Once his armored force was sort of in a better condition, that way he could attract it from a lot more angles. Again, he keeps pushing and pushing and pushing. Joe is desperate. Problem is now, Jesslyn's almost got no resources for now. That King Tiger, and again, he's just sort of milling about there, taking a lot of hits there without really achieving much. Crushing a few false gunners in the process, but getting Panzer Faust in. I mean, he could have actually knocked out the spare Panzer Quartz instead. So, right there again. Hatchell, I think, just called off and said he got, again, too greedy, too, just wanting to see the Jagdpanzer dead, overextending, crossing a lot of armor, and his tank destroyer leaning now open to a second counterattack here with a fresh count King Tiger up from Jesslyn.
Enemy forces are capturing our supplies.
So, yeah. I mean, sometimes you just need to break off an assault and, you know, reorganize. Sadly, what not did here, more mines going off, picking a few conscripts. King Tiger rolling ahead for the fatherland. Rather risky, but at the same time, he knows, and Joe's lost a lot. He doesn't have a lot to punish the King Tiger with. Got a marked vehicle off there, Betty 2. Field gun and the cartridge, but quickly cleared out here by the King Tiger. The Königstiger. Jaeger's here, Betty 5 as the cartridge out in the open. Jagdpanzer almost done. Jump on here versus conscripts. Engaging here, King Tiger on his only marked vehicle. I think that's pretty optimistic there by Joe. And it goes straight into the Jagdpanzer and coupled. Another Russian tank blown up, and with that, I think Jove here is broken. GG, game over, victory for Jesslyn. Hard fought battle here, but I think Jove made a few mistakes. A, I think it would benefit a lot from Lisa Mortar, heavy mortar though, a bit of a two there versus Jesslyn. B, too many head on attacks and too much sort of focus here, not enough sort of trying to maneuver and flank Jesslyn from sides. I think they've done a lot more good, and once the Jagdpanzer was out, I think it should have made initially a much greater effort to actually hunt it down and wreck it, rather than just allowing it to take shots here and there. Feeding it experience, quickly turning into a monster, and then of course when it came to it with the final assault again, he was close, but again he should have pulled back, reorganized, and then, you know, tried to push it again. Instead he just sent Kemp 17 units in piecemeal into his base, taking a lot of damage and then getting a wreck there. So Joe then in the end, I think, getting a bit too desperate after, you know, he created a monster and then getting punished for creating said monster. Jesslyn overall playing quite well, steady hand and sort of good attacks, also a bit, I think, better control the rest of the map there compared to Jove. So there you go, I hope you enjoyed this match, I hope you learned something from it. If you did, why not subscribe, tell a friend, share it with everyone. If not, send in replay fights or feedback in the comment section. If you wish to send in replay alone, links are in the video description. Do provide details as to who you are in the match and, you know, a link to where you are on the rankings. This is Imperial Dating. Cheers. Thank you all for watching. Hope to see you tomorrow for another exciting episode. Bye.